We got to the hunt area on Friday afternoon, the night before our hunt, and glassed a little bit and saw a lot of sign, a lot of good country. Ended up coming back first thing in the morning. And when we did, immediately, once we walked in, we started hearing some bugles and saw a lot of elk in the area. Saw a lot of cows and some smaller bulls. Didn't see any big ones in our general vicinity. But as we walked and glassed a little bit more, we saw a group of elk pretty much on the furthest peak that we could see. And through the binoculars could tell this bull was really nice. We put the spotters up, and sure enough, it was the one that we'd come for. So we put our heads together, made a game plan, and Jerry and I decided to the area that we were going to go up to, marked him on Onyx, and his dad and Charles stayed back with the spotters to help guide us in. So we walked around to the area that we knew he was last, and the wind was blowing. It was howling pretty hard, but we got to the area, and we took us about an hour to get over there. But we did see an elk, one of the cows, up eating, so that gave us a good idea of the area that bull was at. And talking to Wayne and Charles on the spotting scopes, we had a really good idea, but we couldn't find him because he was bedded for a while. But we knew if we stayed in that area, eventually we would see him.
All right, we got those bulls down there. One bull. There's some cows. We're sitting up here, waiting for him to get up. You can see one cow down there. He just bedded in the trees. Jared's ready to
go.
You ready? As soon as he comes from out of those trees, we're gonna get him. Jared, I think I see him. I see his horns through that tree there. He's just kind of slowly moving it back and forth.
After he got up, we watched him mill around for quite a while. He was grazing, and we were just waiting for him to give us that broadside shot. He worked his way up the mountain a little bit. Jared was all ready, set up, ready to shoot. As you'll see here in a little bit, I told Jared to let me know when he was going to shoot, but unfortunately, he didn't hear me because he already had his ear protection in. So I didn't get advance warning to put mine in, and my left ear was ringing, as you'll see here in a little bit.
You hit him. Yeah, you definitely hit him. Hey, put another one in him, Jerry. You got him there? Put another one in him. Oh, shoot. Low and left. That hit him. Left. Hit him again. Aim a little more. Aim a little more right. You're low and left. There we go. That's him.
Got him?
Down.
I got him?
He's down. He's down.
Did I miss him twice?
I think you hit him. I think he's stunned. I'm not exactly sure.
God. I got him. That's the one. You're cold.
Oh my gosh, you didn't tell me about the first shot. My ear is done.
We waited about 10 minutes to make sure that he was done, and then started the trek down. Had a little trouble finding him. It was pretty thick down there, but had to go back to the video and figured out exactly where he was at, and then we went and found him. All right, he should be just over this thing here. Is that him?
Yep,
there he is.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, wow. That's a nice bull, Jaren. That's a nice bull. Told you his thirds were good.
Dude.
Everything's so good.
Everything's good.
Oh my.
That a baby, Jaren. My guiding fee just went up, by the way. All right, elk down. Looks like he got in a couple fights here. Didn't break anything off, though. Impressive, Jared. Very impressive. Love this. Love this guy.
Last time, 7x6. Hey, you doing that? 7x7, baby.
Oh, yeah, Mark. Yep, count that.
Sign. Little devil's tip.
All right, so we were right at the top here. Shot, let's see, there's that tree. So yeah, we shot from right behind that log there. It's falling down. Ooh, how far was it, Jerry?
250?
275,
yeah, once he moved. And hit him right here, and he didn't go far. He dropped. Boom. Congrats, Jerry. I don't know what he scores, but that's a nice bull. We'll have to go back and officially score him. I'm not going to throw out any guesses, but I think I know.
If I can make a living from walking in the woods, you can bet I'd be sitting pretty good, high on a hill, looking at a field downwind. If I can make a nickel off of turning in bass, never worry about the price of gas, I'd be wheeling and dealing and sitting there reeling them in. Hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Early in the morning.
This was Charles's first elk hunt, and he quickly learned it wasn't the easiest country to navigate.
All right.
Can you imagine climbing Everest?
We are. We think we're victorious hunters. We're just trying to scout it now. We're just trying to get to it. James and Jared drove, and they thought it would be faster to let me and Wayne walk, and it's just ridiculous. But look at the view, though. Too bad I'm looking down the whole time. Just a beaut. We got an elk. I've been hiking for what feels like forever. A little over a mile in the worst terrain ever. This is the worst hike I've been on in a long time. Oh my goodness. It was brutal. I didn't think I was gonna die, but I mean, it was intense. It was the third worst walking experience I've had. The other two were in the military. One when I had almost had, where I think I probably had heat exhaustion, just didn't realize it. This one was bad. I felt sick to my stomach and fatigued for a while afterwards. I think they're a mile and a half away and they've got like 900 feet of elevation change also.
Alright, the fun part. Alright, we got everything all loaded up. Let's go. Alright, Jared, get it done.
My gun.
I'll get your gun. Start walking. No, not that way.
Right there.
Go to the trail.
Yeah, you're like 10 feet down.
Alright, here we go. Fun part. Jared, how easy is it to get through these trees?
These are thorn trees.
I don't know how these guys walk around.
How do I get through here? Can't grab a tree either.
Oh, these little trees, you can see it because this one didn't have leaves. Oh, little stickers like rose bushes tearing us up. That entire hillside is covered with these. Brutal. Whew, it's like this steep climb.
Fly away.
You can't stop walking. We're back. We got the first load out. It was about a mile. First quarter mile was really difficult with all the thick trees, but made it out and went back, got the rest of the meat, and then dropped the packs and headed back to camp.
But I like to do just what I like. I'll take the chance, dance the dance. It might be wrong, but then again it might be right. There's no way of knowing what tomorrow brings. Life's too short to waste it, I say.
Plus 12.75
plus
20
plus
18.5 16.25
yeah
17.75
75 oh change 13.25 keep going
36
36 oh the mass it's on okay, yeah
8 plus 7 plus 7 plus 6.25 plus 9 plus 6.25 or 6.5 plus 6.5 plus 6.5.
Where are we at? It's just like 3:48.
3:50 with the devil tines and stuff.
What was it? 3:62.
Yeah.
3:62.
Let's do one more double check.
All right, Charles, what we got here? Expert.
Okay, the last one, 6.5 plus 6.5 plus 6.5. Boom! 3:62.
62.
Nice. Jared, you happy with that?
Oh, yeah.
We woke up this morning to a nice wintry mix over here. Got a bunch of snow. It was raining hard last night, and then it quit raining. We were happy, and we came outside and realized it just turned into snow.
We have to get out of here before we get snowed in.
Nice.
I was raised off of Route 3, out past where the blacktop ends. We'd walk to church on Sunday morning, race barefoot back to Johnson's Fence. That's where I first saw Mary, on that roadside picking blackberries. That summer I turned a corner in my soul down that red dirt road. It's where I drank my first beer. Full of sinners and believers. Learned that happiness on earth ain't just for high achievers. I've come to know there's life at both ends of that red dirt road. Her daddy didn't like me much. Goodbye, shackled up GT.
Why don't you Google elk cow calls and elk bull calls and listen to them, and then you can tell me how good I did. But pretty much you're going to hear the exact same thing. It's just wasting your time.